Hello and good morning, friends. I hope you're having a great day. I want to talk to you about something very, very important, and that is pressure tanks that are waterlogged. And how do you know if your pressure tank's waterlogged? Let's get into it. So when you have a well, right, you're going to have the pump in the actual well column itself, but then you're going to have a thing called a pressure tank. Generally, in our area, they're blue. They're quite large, right? They're almost kind of like this, you know, smaller version of a water heater. Sometimes they're a little bit about the same size as one, depending, right? So the pump is going to get the water into the home. And what it's going to do is it's going to pressurize that tank. And then that tank is specifically going to be pushing the water through the rest of the home, right? Now, generally how they're built is out of steel, but sometimes you'll get some fiberglass ones. Sometimes you'll get some cheaper ones. Sometimes you'll get more expensive ones. But basically how it's going to work is you're going to have a big steel canister with the bladder in the middle. You'll have air up top and water in the bottom. So what'll happen is the pump will push the water into the tank. That will compress the air in the top of the tank. When the pump is off, then that compressed air will push the water through the rest of the home. Generally, in our area, you'll see a 30-50 switch or a 40-60 switch. So what that means is when the pressure drops to 30 PSI or 40 PSI, the pump will kick on. It will compress that air until it gets to 50 or 60 PSI. Now, over the course of time, that bladder is going to expand and contract over and over and over and over until one day it ruptures, right? The most common cause for that to rupture is not keeping enough air up top, right? So you need a little bit of air to balance out the pump that's pushing the water in. So what that means is the pre-charge up top should always be 2 PSI lower than the cut-on, right? So in this case, let's say we have a 40-60 switch. So the 40 PSI is what will cut the pump on. So you want to have at least 38 PSI of air in top of that pressure tank. Now, generally you'll lose between 1 to 2 PSI of air every year. Not a big deal. But let's just say you go 10 years and you've never recharged your tank. Now you're going to run into a problem of that bladder is going to overexpand and potentially rupture. And you might be asking, well, why does that matter? Well, the well pump is going to get that pressure up to 60 PSI regardless of how much air's in there, right? So if you don't have enough air, the pump's gonna put more water in the tank to compress that little bit of air even further till it gets to the 60 PSI. Now, over the course of many years, if you do nothing, that bladder will eventually rupture, and then now you have a waterlogged tank. And you might be asking, well, how do I tell if I have a waterlogged tank? Unless you're sitting right next to the pressure tank, listening while you're running water, it's a little bit more of a nuanced method to detect it as a homeowner. The way that you'll usually see it is you'll be running water and then it'll speed up and slow down, speed up and slow down. And it'll usually be somewhere in like a 5 to 10 second interval, right? It'll be pretty obvious once you know what you're looking for, but if you're not used to seeing that sort of thing, it might be a little bit tricky for you at first, right? So the other way that you can tell is, let's just say you're doing laundry, your laundry machine's next to the pressure tank, or you have a utility sink down there. If you let that sink run while you're standing next to it, you'll hear the pump click on, and in less than 30 seconds, it'll click off. Most commonly, pressure tanks that are waterlogged, it'll be a 5 second to 10 second cycle. After you've already noticed the surging in your pipes, you've already noticed the short cycle, the next thing you're going to do is take off the cap for the Schrader valve, which is that little tire pressure connection point on top, and then put your finger in the hole, and then basically if water shoots out, it's done, right? Sometimes air will also come out, but it's not as common, right? Most of the time you'll see that it'll be a little bit of air with some water to it. Sometimes if you're really unlucky, it'll be just a jet of water comes out, right? So what happens if you have a pressure tank and you do nothing when it's waterlogged? Well, you'll still have water, right? But you're gonna have some weird pulsations. You may not have very great pressure throughout the home, but what'll happen is you'll overwork the pump, all right? So remember earlier we discussed that the on-off cycle is what burns up a pump, right? So if you're constantly on-off, 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 you're not giving that pump enough time to dissipate that heat and to kind of rev up to its designed capacity, right? So if you're on, off, on, off, on, off, eventually you're gonna overwork the pump. It'll bind up, it'll seize, it'll melt itself. Whatever it wants to do, it'll eventually fail pretty quick, right? So a bad pressure tank, not only do you have to replace that, if you don't replace that soon enough, now you're gonna be replacing the tank and the well pump, and nobody wants to do that, right? So generally, I would say that most pressure tanks kind of last like a water heater. They'll go 10, 15 years, give or take, depending on the model. Most manufacturers will warranty it for between 3 to 7 years, depending on the brand you go with, right? I've seen pressure tanks go up to 30 years. I replaced one yesterday. It was from 1988. Like, they work just fine. They decide that they want to last for quite a while, and then they do, right? So just because you have a pressure tank that's looking a little old or looking a little rough doesn't mean you're going to have to replace it pretty soon, but you are going to need to make sure that you start budgeting for that eventual replacement, right? Waterlogged pressure tanks are not a good idea to let just kind of do its thing. You got to make sure, if you do notice any of those signs, again, surging of the water, short cycle at the pressure switch, or water shooting out of the valve, it's time to get it replaced. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. I love having conversations with you guys. Tell me in your experience, have you ever had to replace a pressure tank? I look forward to talking to you guys soon. Hit that like button, hit subscribe. Till next time.